A visit to the O.J. Knorr Turfgrass Research and Education Facility. We're visiting today with Tom Schwab, superintendent of the station, University of Wisconsin in the College of Agricultural and Life Sciences, Madison, Wisconsin, and I'm C.V. Kenyon. Tom, give us an idea what kind of research goes on here at the station.
We've got soil science, horticulture, entomology, and plant pathology work going on here. At the present time, there's probably 50 different studies going on the facility. There's just so much going on.
Tom, maybe you can give us an example of the main focus of the station.
To serve the profession, so the sports field managers, golf course superintendents, sod farms, lawn care companies, and of course homeowners and anybody else that needs turf grass information. We try to serve everybody in the industry.
And can you give us an example of a research project going on out here?
A recent one that we just started this summer is looking at different rusts, a disease that affects turf grass, and it can be real bothersome, and if it gets severe, it can do severe damage to turf grass. And in the past, we just thought a certain rust was hitting turf grass, and now we're finding out that there's four or five different rusts that infect turf grass, and we're trying to map which ones do the most damage and where they're located throughout the state.
While we're talking about that, can you describe what rust does, what it looks like?
Rust tends to show up on grass when it slows down. These rust-colored pustules show up on the outside of turf grass, and until you get the grass growing again, they can be unsightly and can do this damage to turf grass.
Tom, maybe you can give us a little idea of where the station is going to go in the future.
Well, it's going to continue to do more and more studies, more environmental studies. Of these 50 studies that are going on, everyone has an environmental component to it because we want to maintain turf grass that can withstand drought better, use less pesticides and fertilizer. Breeders are breeding grasses that don't need as many inputs.
And Tom, maybe I can get you to paint a little picture of the station here.
We're located in Verona, right next to University Ridge Golf Course. It's about 12 miles west of campus. We started out as 13 acres 25 years ago. We're now up to 25 acres, which I think will serve the industry for a long time in the future.
And Tom, maybe give us a little snapshot of the turf industry here in the state.
It's a billion-dollar industry and employing 30,000 people throughout the state. So it's about the fourth biggest agricultural industry in Wisconsin. The turf industry is growing and very bright for the future, and we hope to keep serving Wisconsin's citizens.
We've been visiting with Tom Schwab, superintendent of the O.J. Knorr Turfgrass Research and Education Facility, University of Wisconsin in the College of Agricultural and Life Sciences, Madison, Wisconsin, and I'm C.V. Kenyon.